Hi, welcome to Ed Foodie. We're getting into the cooler weather in Houston, which means 40 degrees for a high. It's pretty cold. So I found a few good soup recipes that I'd like to try. Today we're going to do an Italian wedding soup. There's lots of different versions of this. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna put a little bit of pasta in this. But first thing we'll do is make the meatballs, bake them, and while the meatballs are baking, we'll make the soup. So let's get started. All right, I've got about a half a pound of ground beef, and to it, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of, it's called cassava flour. It's actually made from the yucca root, and I'm reading the back of this, and you can use this for any other kind of flour as well, so it won't go to waste. We're going to add 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 teaspoon of onion powder, and 1 teaspoon of dried oregano leaves. 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt and 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper. All right, so we're gonna mix these up into little meatballs. I'm making 2 pretty good sized bowls for lunch today. So I'll try to do 12 small meatballs so I can get 6 in each bowl. So we'll mix these up. So I'm gonna make mine pretty small, about maybe the size of a walnut. So this turned out good. As you see, I got 20 pretty small meatballs, fairly uniform. We're gonna bake these in the oven at 350 degrees, about 15 minutes. And while those are baking, we can start on the soup part. All right, so while we got those meatballs cooking, baking in the oven, we're gonna start on the soup. So I've got 2 tablespoons of olive oil in my little Dutch oven. I'm going to add 1 chopped medium onion. We'll cook it until it becomes nice and translucent and soft. All right, so the onions have been sauteing for about 3 minutes. So now we're gonna add in about 3/4 cup of chopped carrots. I had the mini carrots, so I just made mine little thin slices. And we'll just continue sauteing, stir every once in a while for about 4 minutes until these carrots get a little bit tender. All right, the 4 minutes are up with the carrots. Now we'll add in, I got about 2 ribs of chopped celery. Saute these for about 2 more minutes.
Salt and pepper to taste.
Now I guess for the Italian part.
Add 3 cloves of minced garlic.
Garlic smells good. Now I've got 1 quart of vegetable broth. You can use chicken broth. We just tend to use vegetable broth most of the time. So we're gonna bring this to a boil, then turn it down and let it simmer for about 10 minutes. And then we'll be ready to finish the final pieces and serve this up. So let's get the meatballs out of the oven. It's been 15 minutes. They look good. So what we're gonna do now is put these meatballs in the soup. Bring it simmer for about 10 more minutes just to make sure all the meat's cooked inside and to get all these flavors to mix together. Oh, you can really smell that oregano. It smells so good. All right, so let's put this back on the burner. We'll simmer for 10 minutes. And right before we serve, I'm gonna turn it up to a boil. I want this soup real hot when I pour it on, because what I'm gonna do is have two separate bowls. I've got some pasta I wanna add to each bowl, and some, I'm going to add Chinese cabbage. Normally, Italian wedding soup, I think, has escarole or endive. We had Chinese cabbage, so that's what I'm using today. All right, so the soup is very hot. I brought it back up to a boil.
The last step is to add 1/2 tablespoon apple cider vinegar.
Just to give it a little tartness. Now, how we're gonna serve this, I kinda like the way Catherine does this on her soup. We're gonna put some individual things in each bowl. So I've got my empty bowl. I'm gonna put in about 1/4 cup of, I've just got some shell pasta. Maybe I'll put a little bit more, maybe 1/2 cup. And this is already pre-cooked. And then here is my Chinese cabbage, just kind of chopped it up. You can use the escarole if you want. So that's what we have. Now I'm just gonna pour the soup on top, making sure we've got enough meatballs for each one. Oh, looks good. And then we'll top it off with a nice big sprig of basil. And doesn't that look good? We could also top it with a little bit of parsley flakes. Optional, of course. And there we have it. Now we'll give it a taste. Try our Italian wedding soup.
Okay. Looks good.
It is. You know, I retired from Hess Oil and Gas, and we had a cafeteria in the building for the Hess employees, and they had Italian wedding soup, you know, once in a while. I'd never heard of it till I had it there, and I loved it, so I'm really anxious to try this. Really good.
Yeah, very good. This time,
keep your zen. And the Chinese cabbage is going to work fine because it's a little bit crunchy, but it, you know, cooks pretty much like the escarole. Wow, nice, good on a cold winter day. So, if you like this recipe, give me a thumbs up, and please subscribe to Ed Foodie. Right over there somewhere.